Hey guys, welcome to my channel. Today's video is gonna be a thrift haul. If you're new to my channel, I thrift all the time. I have a series called the Buy Chloe Win $25 Thrift Challenge. I've made 40 episodes for that series so far. And basically what you don't know is that I've been thrifting in addition to that series this past couple of months, just collecting pieces here and there when I wanna thrift, but I don't have a full 2 to 3 hours to film. I just pop in and like go through the racks. And so I've just been collecting pieces. I haven't really worn any of these. I've put them like to the side just so I could do this video. So all of this stuff has been from the past couple of months. We went up to Michigan a couple weeks ago and I got some stuff up there, and then I've just kind of bounced around different locations in Nashville as well. So I wanted to do a try on haul for you and show you everything I've gotten in the last couple of months. So let's get into it. So the first piece that I got is this really adorable blush button-down, and I can't remember where I got most of these pieces because it's been quite a few weeks since I picked them up, but I love the fabric on this shirt and it has this really simple pleat in the back, but I really love the button detailing down the front and kind of these like tiny little pleats right here. So I'm gonna show you what this one looks like on. So this is the blush top, and when I first got it, I was like, that feels a little bit dated, but I'm honestly really glad I tried it on and I gave it a chance because the color is really, really pretty. And honestly, the color's not even translating very well onto camera, but I went ahead and tucked it in. I feel like that gives it a little bit more of a modern look. Honestly, wearing this with like white pants would be cute as well, but I love the collar on it and these little pleats down the front. I think that's a fun detail. The next piece that I got is a sweater tank because I just couldn't pass up a good sweater tank, and it's striped. If you guys have watched any of my thrift challenges from last year, like last summer, I picked up so many striped tank tops and striped t-shirts, and then this year I was trying to be like really conscious about what striped pieces I was getting, but I really love this one on, and it's actually kind of like a crop. It has a square neckline, which is also what I liked about it, and then it has really great fall colors, so I feel like this would be a great transition piece into fall. You could throw a cardigan over it and it just seems like a really easy to wear top. So this is that sweater tank, and my favorite part about it is the neckline. I love this square neckline. I think that just adds some interest to it, but I love the fit of it. I went ahead and tucked it into my jeans. Side note, these are the best jeans I've ever owned. If you were looking for an incredible pair of denim, seriously check these ones out. I'm gonna link them down below. I suggest these to literally everyone because they're so dang good. They are a super high rise, so they are very form-fitting, but they're also really stretchy, so they're really comfortable to wear. I always get so many compliments in these jeans, and yeah, they're just some of my favorites. They're basically featured in like every one of my lookbooks because I just wear them all the time. So thought I would just put that out there. If you're looking for some jeans, check these ones out. But yeah, I love this tank top, and honestly, this is probably one of my favorite like tank tops I've found. The next piece that I got is a really pretty skirt. This one has the most beautiful flowers on it. I love this skirt. I can't remember if it's a midi or a maxi. It feels like a midi to me, but it's just this giant floral pattern all the way down, and it's really gorgeous on. It's not like super tight, so it moves beautifully, but I thought this would be really cute with like a white t-shirt or a white sweater tank and just kind of wearing it casually. So I am very into kind of vintage floral prints, and this was such a find. So this floral skirt is more like a maxi than a midi actually, because I'm pretty short, but it's also a little big, so I think I'm gonna have to take it in just a little bit for it to hit on my waist correctly. But for the purpose of this video, I've just paired it with a white t-shirt that I've tied in the front, and I just think this skirt is so cute. It would look great with a basket bag. Honestly, skirts are so comfortable, so I'm really happy I found this one. And the length really doesn't bother me because I love not having to worry about things being too short or like coming up. This skirt is super cute and I can't wait to style this one more. The next piece is a little bit funky, and I do remember where I got this one. I got this at Salvation Army in Michigan, and I actually wore this one on a post on my Instagram. So if you wanna check that out, my Instagram's at @bychloewin, and I post a lot of outfits and a lot of my everyday life. So if you wanna follow me on there, I highly suggest it. But this piece is super funky and really 90s. I love this this top though. I just thought one day I'm probably gonna regret wearing this because it's just kind of dated. But at the same time, life is so short and it's fun to kind of jump on those trends, especially when I think this was only 99 cents, so it didn't really cost me anything. And so if I don't end up wearing it in like a year, it's okay. So yeah, this is a really fun, I call it my Barbie tank, but basically it's like one of those stretchy tops and it has a little bit of a crop, but I think I tucked it into some mom jeans in that post. But I really loved this. I thought the pattern and the color was just so fun, and I honestly don't own a lot of pink, so this is a fun addition to my wardrobe.
So this is the Barbie top, and as you can see, it's very funky. I really do love all of the different colors in it, and it is fun that it has that like stretchy texture. Honestly, it's not that soft, like it's kind of itchy, but I did wear it for an entire day and I survived, so I think it's doable. But I don't know if I will keep this for very long. I just thought it was so fun and it really stuck out to me on the rack. I feel like this is a really trendy top, but I'm all about trying out trends and just seeing if they work for me, and I think this one was a good score.
This next piece you guys are gonna have to see on because it doesn't really look very good when I hold it up, but I got this gorgeous silk Alice and Olivia blouse. As you can see, it just looks like a white blob, but if you look closely you can kind of tell that it has this tie in the front that you can tie into a bow, and then the sleeves are actually these like big bell sleeves. So I thought this top was so gorgeous, and it's like a really bright white and it's not stained, which I was really impressed by because I feel like most white shirts that I find at like a Goodwill or any other thrift store is usually kind of stained around like the neckline from makeup. So super happy about this top. It has this really kind of pretty cinched ruffle in the back, and it's just a really classic top. I thought this would look so good with a pair of heels or just dressed down with some mom jeans. So this one is really fun.
So this Alice and Olivia top definitely looks better on than it did when I was just holding it up. You can actually see how beautiful the sleeves are. They even have these like buttons on them, which is a gorgeous detail. But the fabric is seriously so soft and so silky, and then the bow just lays gorgeously across the front. So I love this shirt. I think this one is such a great find.
So this next piece is really trendy, but I've honestly been looking for something in this beautiful purple color. I'm really happy I found this. I believe it was like $2. It was on sale, and it's just a really trendy dress. It has this cinch in the front and it's really form-fitting, but honestly it's so flattering on, and I just really love this color. I've been wanting to find something this color. I feel like this is a very trendy shade of purple right now, but I've been really into color and pastels lately. As you can tell, my nails are green, so I've been on that train. So this one is really cute on.
So this is the purple dress, and as you can see it has this like asymmetrical cut. I love the slit in the front. I think that's really fun. This is obviously a very trendy piece. I don't know how much wear I'll get out of it, but honestly, even if I just wore it for some photos, I feel like that's a win. But it actually fits really nicely. When I tried it on in the dressing room, I was kind of shocked because I didn't think it would look good, but I really love the way that it looks. It's kind of styled like a wrap dress, but the great part is that it doesn't come unwrapped. It's super stretchy and comfortable, and I don't know, I'm trying to figure out where I'm gonna wear this.
The next piece is kind of basic, but I've seen a ton of bloggers and YouTubers wearing this style of top, so I wanted to get one for myself, and I thought the perfect place to find it would be a thrift store. So I got this cream button-down top. I've seen so many people tucking these button-down sweaters into jeans, and I just love the look of that, so I wanted to find one, and luckily I did. I found it yesterday, actually. So this one is kind of like an off-white. It has a ribbed material, and it's just a really simple sweater. I think the brand is Ann Taylor, so kind of nice.
This sweater tucked in is so cute. I absolutely just love the simplicity of this entire look. I could throw on sneakers or wear this in the fall with some boots or sandals even. I really love the material of this, but I feel like this would be a really great look to add chunky gold jewelry with, and maybe even like a statement bag or something like that to kind of dress it up. But this is what the texture looks like up close.
The next piece is actually a sweater, and even though it's like 10,000 degrees outside, I had a shoot this morning and I almost like died from the heat. My bangs were so gross and sweaty. Anyway, I got a sweater, and the reason reason I got this sweater though is because of the color. I thought this color was just so cute. I don't have a sweater in this color, so this is just like a little baby blue sweater, and it has the prettiest stitching detail. I don't know if you call that stitching detail, knit detail, as well as on the bottom. So I loved this sweater though. It just looks really cute with some white jeans.
This sweater is the most beautiful blue, and I really love the fit of this. This must be like a petite size because the sleeves are a little bit shorter than a normal sweater. Typically the sleeves on sweaters are really long on me, and these ones like fit kind of perfectly. I love the length of the sleeves and this detailing around kind of like the neck area and the sleeves. I think it just adds a nice element to it, but the sweater would look really great with some white jeans or maybe even a skirt.
So this last piece is my favorite, that's why I saved it for last, but it's so beautiful and I honestly cannot believe I found this dress. You guys probably have picked up on the fact, well, if you've been with my channel, that I love and adore red dresses. I think red just looks really great with my dark hair, with my skin tone, and I don't know, it's just like a bold statement look. So I found this gorgeous Betsy Johnson red dress. And it's so, so pretty. It's almost like a baby doll style. Like, it flares out a lot. It's super wide. You guys are gonna have to see this one on because I really can't show you how beautiful it is by holding it up. But I love the fabric. It's super lightweight and the sleeves are huge. So they move so beautifully. They have these ruffles on the bottom and the sleeves are sheer, which is what I love as well. This has a giant ruffle on the very bottom, and then it actually ties around the waist. So I'm gonna just put this one on for you because it's so pretty.
So this is the Betsy Johnson dress, and it's honestly so perfect. Obviously, you don't need a lot to dress this thing up. It's so beautiful though. My favorite part are the sleeves. I think the sleeves are so fun. I love that they're sheer, and I think everything about this dress just moves really well. I love the neckline on this. I feel like it's the perfect V-neck, and then it has a bow in the back, which ties really nicely. Honestly, you guys, how can you not be obsessed with this dress? I think I got it for maybe $6, and this would be so cute with some heels or sandals. Could wear it to a wedding. I'm so happy I found this, and this is kind of what the pattern looks like up close. These tiny little flowers. Honestly, I'm so obsessed with this dress.
So that's everything for this thrift haul. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I'll be sure to link my $25 thrift challenge series down below for you to check out. If you like this video though, please give it a big thumbs up and leave me a comment down below letting me know what your favorite piece was. Don't forget to subscribe if you love thrifting and you want to see more of my videos, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye!